artist in Cebu City was arrested for supposedly posting misinformation on social media about the spread of the new coronavirus. In a now-deleted Facebook post, Maria Victoria Beltran said there were over 9,000 new cases of COVID-19 in Sitio Zapatera in Cebu City. The artist claims her post was satirical, but Cebu City Mayor Edgardo Labella said it caused panic among residents. Joining us now is attorney Amando Virgil Ligutan. He's the lawyer of Maria Victoria Beltran. Good morning, attorney Ligutan, and thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Christian, and to all the televiewers.
So where is Ms. Beltran now? Has she posted bail?
She is about to post bail this morning. She is facing three charges, Christian, for posting something on Facebook. And the post is based on actual news reports by the local news outlets here in Cebu City. Mm. So I repeat, the post is based on actual news reports here in Cebu City.
So when you say actual news report, what exactly was the news report about? Because yes. I think the contentious post said that 9,000 plus new cases, all from Zapatera. Okay. So there was an actual news report about this?
Okay, thank you for pointing that out. You know what? I would like to point out, Christian, that when Mayor Labella was interviewed yesterday, he was only telling half of the story and he was actively concealing the other half. Christian, I would like to show you this. This is an actual headline, banner headline of a news outlet here in Cebu City saying that the entire area is contaminated and or infected. I repeat, when Ms. Beltran posted, she did not know, and by that I mean, before she posted that, she did not have any idea as to, number one, the number of residents inside Sitio Zapatera. But it was after reading the reports. It was after hearing the news. In fact, Christian, it was DOH-7 which said that the entire city of 9,000 residents, I repeat, entire city of 9 residents is now considered contaminated and or infected. Now, if you are an ordinary netizen, what will come to your mind after hearing such report? Only one conclusion, and that conclusion she posted on Facebook. So this is something that we would like to point out. Each and every part of the post was based on actual news report that Ms. Beltran heard on social media, read on social media, on radio, and on television, and on print, Christian. Okay. So for us, that is so unfair for Ms. Beltran to be charged with fake news when in fact she didn't know anything about it right before she heard the news, she read the news, and she reported that on Facebook. So in short, Christian, Ms. Beltran is just reporting, slash restating, slash reposting what she heard, what she read on the news. So it's unfair for her to be charged with that, Christian.
So the mayor should have run after the actual source of that information, not Ms. Beltran, who was only commenting on that particular information that she had read. Is that what you're saying here?
I'm not saying it should be the DOH-7. It should be the DOH-7. You know what? It's so unfair for someone to rely on the news and post something on what she reads on the news and be prosecuted for such. It is so unfair. And I would like to make another point, Christian. I heard the mayor saying yesterday that he promised Ms. Beltran the rudiments of due process, that her rights should be protected. But you know what? I have to point out the mayor was being hypocritical. You know why? Because the mayor slash the accuser talked to Ms. Beltran while Ms. Beltran was inside the police station. And while the mayor was talking to Ms. Beltran, Ms. Beltran's lawyer was not allowed to enter because of the presence of the mayor. So the camp of Ms. Beltran, headed by attorney Vincent Isles, is in fact about to file criminal charges against the mayor for violation of the custodial investigation law.
Mm. What so did the mayor tell her?
It was critical for a mayor to promise.
Oh.
Okay.
What did the mayor tell her?
Again, the mayor, sorry, but the mayor is being hypocritical.
Oh, pero ano yung sabi ng mayor during that conversation? Kasi,
yes.
Because based on the interview yesterday, he also said that he was not onion skinned. But I was saying, kung hindi ka onion skinned, why would you go to the extent of filing a case against this person? But I'm curious about what he told her in that detention facility.
You know what? Yeah, you know what he told her? He told her that he had nothing to do with it.
He denied it.
He had nothing to do with it. Yes, in front of Ms. Beltran. In front of Ms. Beltran, the mayor denied having any hand on her arrest. And in fact, everyone in Cebu City knows that it was the mayor who ordered the arrest of Ms. Beltran. The mayor, I'm sorry, but was being hypocritical.
Let's talk about the longer and wider impact of this particular action by the local government against an ordinary citizen. We know that there's a provision in the Bayanihan Act against the spread of false information. And a lot of people are saying that particular provision is too broad and can easily be abused by certain government officials. What has been the effect on the ground of this particular action by the mayor against Ms. Beltran?
Ms. Beltran is a classic example of what we call lawfare. The government weaponizing the law to run after free speech. Ms. Beltran is not a run-of-the-mill netizen. She is a multi-awarded artist. In fact, Chris, I would like to point out, in 2019, the same Mayor Labella appointed Ms. Beltran to the Cebuano Development Cinema Council. I repeat, the same mayor who ordered her arrest appointed her as part of the commission, the Cebu Developmental Cinema Council. So what the mayor is doing is in fact a travesty of something that we hold sacred, that is free speech. In fact, Ms. Beltran's case is not a case of dissent. Ms. Beltran's case is a case of someone just reporting, just reposting what she read in the news. Common sense, logic, Christian tells us that no one should be arrested for just reposting what one read in the news.
Okay. Attorney Ligutan, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much.